students to Hogwarts. Maybe in Claire's style.
Hey, you guys, this is so exciting. Not only are we celebrating 2022 today, but so much more importantly, we are celebrating 20 years of Harry Potter.
If you guys have been living in a cupboard under the stairs, you may not know that HBO Max just dropped a Harry Potter special where the cast is getting together to relive the magic. And I cannot believe it has been 20 years since the first movie came out.
We are so freaking old.
No, like, what the F? Because I remember the trailer for the Sorcerer's Stone.
We can expect great things from you.
For 2022, we thought, why not just update some of these Harry Potter looks? So we're gonna take three of the most iconic moments and recreate the fashion.
So our moments, starting with playing wizard chess, as they did in The Sorcerer's Stone. And then we're gonna go and save Buckbeak and Sirius in The Prisoner of Azkaban. And then we're all going to put on our best dress robes and dresses and go to the Yule Ball from The Goblet of Fire. I will be restyling Harry Potter.
I will be restyling Ron. Ron Weasley.
And I will be restyling Hermione Granger. Also known as, for a lot of people who read the books, as Hermione.
I say Hermione.
How long did it take you to figure that out?
For the movie.
What?
You're saying it wrong.
20 years ago, Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone hit cinemas everywhere. Drew was a fetus.
I was.
But Bridget and I were there.
We were old chums by that point.
Bloody old, if you ask me.
Bloody freak it out. It's your day, isn't it?
It's been 20 years since Sorcerer's Stone. We wanted to kick it off by celebrating the movie that started it all. Obviously, the books were iconic, but just knowing the hype around Harry Potter, and then knowing that movie was coming out.
I need to confess, just in case it wasn't clear, I didn't read the books.
Never.
But I actually, I did try to read Sorcerer's Stone for about 6 years. And you know, the movie just kept coming out, so.
I didn't read Goblet of Fire. I couldn't get through like 40 pages. I'm really sorry.
Posers over here.
I didn't know you could read.
But that's perfectly okay, however you enjoyed it, whether you saw it in the theater or you read the books. I'm just gonna give you a quick little clip notes about Sorcerer's Stone. It's their first year at Hogwarts. They're trying to manage how to become wizards, how to Wingardium Leviosa. Mm-hmm. And not only that, they think that Snape is trying to get the Sorcerer's Stone.
Mm-hmm.
So then they have to go through all of these obstacles in order to save it. They have to get past Fluffy. They have to get past Devil's Snare.
Okay.
They have to find those keys that get into that lock, that open the door that leads us to the wizard's chest.
Mm.
This is such a dope scene. So this is the first movie, so Hermione's still in her muggle ways, you know, so she's very like prim and proper. And I just tried to honor her in that way. I have my knee-high socks.
Love them.
I have my Mary Jane shoes.
Love them.
My pleated skirt, sweater, turtleneck, and wand insert here. Honestly, it's a whole vibe right now. It makes me want to like read a book and whip up some potions.
I love how you incorporated the turtleneck too. I feel like everyone now is pairing their turtlenecks under like a crew neck or a sweater.
Mm-hmm.
So that is very of the times.
It is. Which apparently is 1980 something. Did you guys know that?
Yeah,
Bridget knew it.
I need your help to get back to the year 1985.
I obviously am Harry Potter, and I thought it was hilarious to like juxtapose all of their battles and stuff with how actually pretty nice they look, you know? I mean, not so much you, but it works for Ron.
What are you saying?
It's not his fault.
You tried.
He just has no money.
Pathetic, isn't he?
I am wearing this red sweater from Aritzia. And then to make it just more Sinead, I put a blue turtleneck underneath it. This one's from Zara, and the pants are from Fashion Nova. They look like slacks, but they're not. I just really like this combo a lot.
I love it.
And then I'm wearing my clonker boots that I wear with everything, and I got these glasses on Amazon. Those big oversized hipster glasses are kind of a little bit out now, so I was like, I'll go for sunglasses.
I like.
I'm obsessed. I just think you did such a good job staying true, but also really amping it up for 2022.
Yeah,
it's super cute.
It actually really works. And I think it's nice too, because it's like winter time, so it feels a little bit like wintry-esque, you know?
Yeah.
All right, ready.
What's going on, Ron?
Okay, I'm dressed as Ron. And in Wizard's Chess, Ron leads the way because as we learn in the books and in the movies, he is really, really good at Wizard's Chess. Like he may struggle with potions, he may struggle with transfiguration, but he is an amazing Wizard's Chess player. So in the movie, he's wearing basic jeans, a basic gray top and a flannel over it. So this is a shacket from Zara. He's wearing more like a reddish dark plaid, but I love the blue, so I wanted to add that. And then the turtleneck I really, really love, or sweater turtleneck, it's from ASOS. It's still gray, so keeping within the color palette, and obviously you guys know I love a sweater.
That's a good sweater.
It's a good sweater. And I just tucked it into these pants from Aritzia, and then I cuffed the bottoms just a little bit. And then for shoes, like I think they wore some type of like dad shoe that's really, really popular now. So these are just the New Balances. I don't know what number they are, but we'll link it below, obviously. These aren't Fred and George's hand-me-downs, okay? These are brand spanking new.
I love it.
Mischief managed.
We are moving on to the third installment, The Prisoner of Azkaban, aka the scariest movie because the Dementors.
This is where the movies and the books, of course, take a darker turn. Mm-hmm. In this particular book slash movie, Harry finds out about a character named Sirius Black, who he overhears killed his parents, betrayed them, and that is why he doesn't have any parents. And then he also finds out that he's his godfather, and you're like, why would that happen? So during the movie, these characters are wearing these outfits for a majority of time, because if you remember, Hermione has the time turner. So they have to do all of the things before, and then she turns back time and they do all of them again. So that's why these are pretty iconic looks.
You're also forgetting about how they go to the Shrieking Shack, find out who Sirius and Scabbers really are, and then they use the time turner to go back in time, then they save Buckbeak, then they save Sirius, and then they stand up to those creepy ass Dementors.
And then Hermione punches Draco in the face.
You guys know we talked about how Ron gets a lot of hand-me-downs from all of his relatives. And in this movie, once they do the time turner, Ron's in the hospital. So he kind of exits for most of the movie. So I was like, you know what? I'm gonna give Ron some sex. I'm gonna throw this kid a bone and how I would restyle it for 2022.
In
the movie, he has on a pair of jeans and a maroon sweater with another color under it. So I wanted to keep true to those colors because that seems to be his palette. So what I did was pair this slip red dress that's from Target. And then I paired it with this maroon leather jacket from Forever 21. And then these boots are from Nordstrom. I did want to do sneakers again, and I really love the juxtapose of a cute little dress with combat boots, very Shanann and Drew-esque. I feel like you guys do this a lot.
I love it.
I mean, you can always find a maroon sweater and some sneakers, but if you want to go a little bit different, I figure this could be cool. And like I said, Ron's in bed. He like doesn't even know what happens. He's like super useless this movie.
What the bloody hell was that all about?
What about you, Addie?
Well, I was looking at his clothing choices and everything. He wears a lot of beige and taupes. And so I wanted to change it up a little bit. So I went with a deeper olive pants. They're just way more modern. They've got like slits in the thighs. They've got pockets. I love the seatbelt detail. They have like a little drawstring. They're actually hella comfortable. And then I got these dad sneakers from Zara.
Those are cool.
These are tight, right? So again, he's wearing like New Balances, but I was like, oh, these are way cooler. He's wearing a t-shirt, but I wanted obviously a little bit more like feminine vibe to it. A little bit more sporty and modern, so I went with a cropped sweater from Aritzia. And then he is wearing an Adidas strap jacket, which is really great for me.
Adidas.
Because I was very upset when I saw that Hermione was wearing Adidas, and I was like, Drew's gonna get new Adidas, and I'm not gonna get any Adidas. And then I literally like panned over an inch, and I was like, Harry's wearing Adidas!
I am just a clone of Hermione right now. This is the exact outfit that she wore in the movie.
Totally.
Newsflash here, for the movie, they shopped at Fashion Nova, because most of these pieces are from Fashion Nova. I was really hyped when I found this zip up because it's like the exact color that she was wearing. But it's a two-piece set. It's like a sweat tracksuit set. And the top underneath is, I think, also from Fashion Nova, but it's a crop top, which is like kind of cute.
Makes I love
it, like,
that.
Updated and sexy and fun. And then the jeans, also from Fashion Nova.
The jeans are the most shocking, I feel like, because they're even in that retro style.
Yeah, and then the blue Adidas.
Classic. I love those.
Like her.
And the fact that like Hermione and Harry are dressed very similarly too, it's like they're equal, like she's just as much of a badass.
Yeah, by Hermione wearing this velour zip up, it's like her coming more into her own, breaking her ways of like being like really prim and proper, and she's like, no, I'm a bad bitch now.
Yeah.
I can wear what I want.
Love it.
You know? Hermione really put in work in this movie.
That felt good.
Moving on to the fourth installment in the Harry Potter series.
Le Goblet.
I don't know why I went French. We are still in English.
Well, there was a French school that was there, so I could see where you were going.
Yeah, okay, okay.
We're in the tournament.
Yeah.
The Goblet of Fire is the fourth installment, as Sinead said. And this is when the Tri-Wizard Tournament takes place. And for those of you who don't know what that is, two other schools come to Hogwarts where they pick a representative from each of the schools to battle in crazy, crazy things. Some wizards die, and then some win. And then some grab a port key and meet Lord Voldemort and don't come back.
But more importantly, this is the movie where we get to experience is the Yule Ball. I think the Yule Ball is just so great, first of all, because it's the only dance that they ever go to.
Yeah.
Second of all, Hermione's dress. Third of all, Hermione's pink dress. And fourth of all, Hermione's pink dress, which I need to talk about, okay? Before you start to massacre me with your fingers, with your Karen fingers in the comment section below, let me just tell you, I had a vision. There were four dresses. Count them. 1, 2, 3, 4. They were perfect. They were sold out. They were gonna get here in time. They were $600. So our lovely producer, Bridget, Bridget's right here. Our lovely producer, Silva, helped me out and sent me like so many of the other selections. Does it look like Hermione's dress? No. Is the color right? Yeah. Are my boobs out? I'm sorry, okay?
Hot, isn't it?
With that being said, we have Hermione Granger Yule Ball inspired. Look, this is from Lulu's. It will set you back not that much. It's this number that's on the screen. It's comfortable. It's flowy, adjustable straps. We love that. Not when I want it, but it's fine. And I think it's a nice substitute. If you want to rock Hermione Granger's look to a dance you're going to, this is an affordable option.
It has the ruffles, has the color, ruffles. Like you said. I think it looks gorgeous on you. I know it wasn't your first pick, which is a real bummer, but like Drew said, we want to make sure these pieces are affordable if you guys want to reshop them.
Hey,
so.
Totally. I was only thinking of you.
During the Yule Ball, traditionally wizards wear dress robes, and Ron unfortunately gets his from his great aunt Tessie, and he unboxes them, and unfortunately he says they smell, and then he sees Hermione, how beautiful she looks, and he's like, oh my god, I like her, I look like this. So again, I wanted to give Ron some sex, I wanted to give Ron some chic, some sophistication, and so I just kept really with the color, and that was it. Like, these are not really reminiscent of robes, obviously, but this is a two-piece set from Shopo, so it has these pants, and then this top with like this plunge neckline, which I thought was really nice, and this material, I don't know what you would call it, but it's like really in this like stretchy kind of textured fabric. It's extremely comfortable and it flares out a little bit at the bottom. I wish they were like a tad longer, but I think it's cute. And then I just paired these kind of clear rose gold shoes with them. And then kind of to incorporate other colors that Ron had, he had a lot of like orange and greens. I got these earrings from Amazon, these just drop green earrings.
I love that.
So and then cute. I put on a bunch of rings. Some colors, some golds. The Sorcerer's Stone is actually right here.
I think it's cool that it's a two-piece because it totally looks like a jumpsuit.
It does.
Yeah,
it really does.
It's
yeah.
nice, and I believe you can also get it in white too. So another color, but I just think it's super holiday-ish and flowy, and I would wear this to a Yule Ball if I was invited.
This is way too old.
I was looking at Harry's outfit and I was like, hell no, I'm not gonna wear anything like that. Here's the things I do like about it. So let's start there. I love how androgynous his outfit is because it actually does like kind of speak to what I like. It's black and white. That's very easy for me. And second of all, it's got clear aspects of masculinity and clear aspects of like a very, very feminine touch.
Yeah.
And I dig it. There's something very sexy about that. So I was like, how do I do that? But in 2022, I got these faux leather bicycle shorts, basically. They're to the thigh with these thigh highs from Fashion Nova, which is great because my dog just ate mine. To add in the cape aspect, I got this sheer like chicken wire with the strap on Amazon, super cheap. And then for the top, because it's long sleeve, it feels very layered. I decided to use my own corset top, which is underneath. It's from Victoria's Secret. I've had it for ages. And then I decided to get the high neck thing using the beads. I decided to trade in my sunglasses and get these bedazzled ones. Just because I wanted him to still have his glasses, but it's the Yule Ball, so he has to have like, you know, some sass.
Murder me, Harry.
Okay, well, I think we personally killed it. In this magical world of fictional characters, of restyling, I think we did an amazing job. So are there any other characters that we should do? Harry Potter Part 2, there's Luna, there's Tonks, there's so many other characters we could do.
And I'm Hagrid.
Hagrid?
Malfoy.
I call Hagrid.
That cat, the little cracked out cat.
Oh, yes, Mrs. Norris. Yeah. So if you guys want us to do a Part 2, obviously leave it below. And I can't wait to see the HBO Max special. I'm gonna watch it right after this.